Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm going to do a classic rock reaction. This is Rush, man. A Rush song called Natural Science. And I just want to give a shout out and a thanks very much to Thor6471. I'm just going to call you Thor, brother. Thank you very much, Thor. I appreciate it, man. I appreciate the recommendations. Actually, quite a few people under your chain there as you were recommending this tune were, yeah, definitely that one. So it was definitely this one. So, hey, man, let's get this popping. I know it's long, but I've come to expect that from a number of Rush songs, taking you on a trip for sure. So I'm sure this is no exception. And ahead of time, pardon me for my loud ass neighbors. They're up already. 4:30 in the morning, they're up. All right, man, let's get this popping. Rush, Natural Science. Let's get it. Singing about the disconnect between like nature and the modern era, technology, something like that. Yeah, there's a disconnect. Thank you. ignorance. Ignorance about how the world works. The balance of the universe. Their musicianship, though. How it just shifts directions. Science, like nature, must also be tamed. His guitar playing, Alex Lifeson, is one of those guitarists who can make that guitar talk to you. That's how we must be sensitive, open, and strong. To survive annihilation. This song carries a strong message, man. It's a warning. Is that it? Okay. I think that's it. Wow. Natural Science. What a song, man. Holy. Only Rush can do it this way, man. A nice, long, introspective look, showing you certain things, speaking to you truthfully about certain things, issuing a warning about certain things. In this case, I believe this song is all about being not connected to nature anymore because of our advanced way of living, our advanced lifestyle, our technology. I think we're disconnected from nature or the way things used to be, more of the wholesome age. That's what I feel that they're saying. And there is a part about getting so advanced that we can annihilate ourselves. So we have to go back to being, open, sincere, and strong. So that's how we have to assume our nature, go back to that, so that we can avoid annihilating ourselves, you know, because we can get so indulgent in our technology and our modern lifestyle, and we're just too far disconnected from, I guess, a more wholesome state of being. I think that's the big picture of what I'm getting about this song. What am I missing? It was a long song, man, 9 minutes, so I know that I missed probably a couple of things. But overall, hey, that fantastic Rush musicianship, man. Oh, man. The musicianship is the first thing I think about when you say Rush to me, the musicianship. And then secondly would be their beautiful, long, Odyssey-like songs that have a great story that they tell. That would be the second great thing about them. And there's just so much. But the musicianship keeps coming back to my head. Their musicianship, man, it's just incredible, you know? The song as well is excellent. It's well balanced. It's got a nice beginning, got that tranquil sound of water, and it just really takes you slowly into this world that they're trying to show you. And yo, the song is excellent. It speeds up in the middle and it gives you a feeling of this is a very serious message type of thing. Musicianship is great, but the tone is very, very, it's got a slight anxiousness to it. They're trying to drive a point home to you with the musicianship. I get it, you know? Fantastic song, well conceived. I understand now why you guys definitely wanted me to check this out, man. It's got a strong message, it's got the story, it's got that sort of thing that you know that I like, right? I think that's why you guys chose this particular song to recommend. You know, you knew that I would like this. That's all right, man, you're getting to know me. Yo, excellent, what can I say? This is an excellent, excellent song. And I can listen to it for hours on end, just put it on repeat, and just get all of the little nuances that I've missed the first time around, the second time around, the third time, and every single successive time you'd listen to the song, I bet you that you'd pick up something that you didn't catch previously. That's what I like about Rush music, man. Just this great odyssey of stuff, this poetic dance that they do, however it is that they do this creative stuff, and put this masterful musicianship in between it to keep you focused, or keep your attention. You don't drift too much, even though it's a long ass song. I didn't find myself drifting, and I was like, holy cow, has 9 minutes gone past already? 9 minutes and 15 seconds or whatever it is. That definitely shows how well crafted they are with their musicianship, their creativity, their storytelling, everything. Okay, man. So I like this song. Let's shut up about it and let's do a little background here. And get a little bit more insight. I'm sure there's a couple of things that I missed. Sorry, man, I'm just trying to catch my, bring up my Wikipedia page here, just to introduce the band. It's kind of circling around, but it's not opening up the page for me. Kind of slow here, man. So, okay, there we go. All right. So, just going to read a little bit about the band and then a little background on the song. So, starting with the band. So, Rush. Rush was a Canadian rock band comprising Geddy Lee, Alex Lifeson, and Neil Peart. Formed in 1968, the band went through several configurations until arriving at its longest and most popular lineup when Peart replaced original drummer John Retzi in July of 74. They had neglected to come up with a name for their group until John's older brother yelled, "You're always on the go. Why don't you call the band Rush?" Rush is known for its musicianship, complex compositions, and eclectic lyrical motives drawing heavily on science fiction, fantasy, and philosophy. The band's musical style has changed several times over the years, from a blues-inspired hard rock beginning, later moving into progressive rock. They're among the most proficient players on their respective instruments, with each band member winning numerous awards in magazine readers' polls. Several industry sources estimated Rush's total worldwide album sales at over 40 million units as of 2017. The group has been awarded 24 gold, 14 platinum, and 3 multi-platinum albums. Fantastic, man. It's a little bit of info on the band. And let's get a little background on this excellent song, man. Natural Science. Natural Science is a song by Canadian rock band Rush. It was released on their 1980 album Permanent Waves as the final song on it. Background. Natural Science is about how people can forget about nature because of technology and how we must value the earth. Producer Terry Brown and assistant Kim Bickerdike used oars in lake water to make the splashing sounds at the beginning of the song. Guitarist Alex Lifeson said, quote, "Once we had the guitar track down, we stuck a speaker cabinet outside. This was up at the studio in Mohr Heights, Quebec, and we recorded the natural echo off the mountains in combination with the sound of splashing water and Geddy's voice. We didn't use any sort of synthetic echo on the water track." The song is about how people can forget about nature because of technology and how we must value the earth. Okay, and that's unquote. There are some odd 7, 8, 6, 8, and 3, 4 time signatures in this song, along with the normal 4-4. Neil Peart had been tinkering with an epic song interpretation of Sir Gawain, G-A-W-A-I-N, and the Green Knight. The song never panned out, but parts were later pulled out and woven into Natural Science. Producer Terry Brown and assistant Kim Bickerdike used oars in lake water. Okay, yeah, it's the same sentence from the previous one, just above. Okay. This is Void drummer Michael Langvin's favorite Rush song. Voivod, V-O-I-V-O-D. Okay, so that is the Wikipedia song fact info of Natural Science. So yeah, pretty accurate song. Encouraging us to get back to more of a natural state. Don't forget about nature. We indulge with our technological lifestyle sometimes and we forget to value the earth. That's very, very true. I mean, geez, you know, these guys were talking about this in the 70s and the 80s in their music, you know. I imagine bands previously before that, even in the 60s. So yeah, quite a strong message. Very, very strong message. Something to really think about. And I love the way they basically present it in song. It gets your attention. It takes your imagination on a bit of a journey, you know. And the musicianship in itself is has a message to it. I like the way Alex Lyson plays his guitar. Some guitarists have that effect on me. So far, there's a couple of guitarists that can play a guitar, and it's as if that guitar is talking to you. You know what I'm saying? That's the effect that Alex Lyson's playing has on me. There's also Hendrix and Page and Stevie Ray Vaughan that has that effect. David Gilmour too, when they play their guitar, it's as if they can talk to me through that playing. It's a very rare thing that I feel connected to certain musicians where it comes to that, you know. Yeah, so they're playing overall, their musicianship is fantastic, man. And, you know, I mean, 200 years from now, when you talk Rush, people will still be talking about Rush. And what's going to come up 200 years from now, I'm betting, is first, their musicianship. I think that they're first going to be remembered overall for their great musicianship. A close second to that would be their ability to creatively tell a great story in a way that captures your imagination, take you on a trip. What would be their third thing? I would say their third thing would be their great ambassadorship, their image. They are very, very well behaved. If you want to idolize yourself after a really great rock group, and you know, they seem very gentlemanly, and I don't know if that's a word, sorry, but they're very likable. That's their image projection to me. They're very likable, very down to earth, very approachable, warm and inviting, and they're kind of like the cool neighbors next door kind of thing. So I really like their public persona, their public image, and that really adds to the appreciation of their music in my mind. What I'm talking about is, I'll give you an example. There are certain musicians, certain actors, based on how they behave, based on their conduct or what have you, sometimes it takes away the appreciation for their craft. It takes away the appreciation for their talent. You know, the things that some people do, who are celebrities, you know, when you're listening to their music, you can't help but be overshadowed by the negativity of their bad public's persona or their bad behavior, that sort of thing. Of course, I'm not going to drop names, but I'm sure that you can come up with a whole bunch of examples in your mind, you know. But these guys, they seem to have a really, really great public persona. I haven't heard anything bad about them. I'm not looking for bad things, but I haven't heard anything negative, you know what I mean? And this is a day and age with social media being all over the place, you know, you can't basically do anything without somebody knowing, you know? So, you know, yeah, these guys are real class acts, and I like their image as well, you know? I'd say also too, give them props for their longevity in the business, sticking to it, not being disillusioned or disappointed in the overall industry, because there was a time, I'm sure, that they could have packed up and quit. I remember someone was saying that their label was going to drop them, and they wanted them to produce certain types of songs, and they're like, yeah, this is your last chance type of thing, and you know, we're going to drop you if you don't give us a hit, but we want you to package it up in kind of like a commercial way, you know, only a couple of minutes long. That's so they kind of went against the grain, but it ended up being a breakthrough all the same. You know what I'm saying? So they've got longevity and they've got lasting power, which is really good. Not only are they capable, of course, of cranking out multiple hits, but they've got longevity, and it seems like they've been very, very consistent over their how many years that they've been around. So, you know, man, Yeah, these guys, they definitely, I have a lot of respect for them. A lot of respect for them, man. Not just their talent, but who they are as people. I really like them. They're very likable. So let me ask you a question, man. Where does Rush rank in your rankings for musicianship, for example? Because I know musicianship will be the number one thing when we talk about Rush 200 years from now. Where do you rank them in among great musicianship? You know, compared to, of course, their contemporaries, and just overall in general for their musicianship, where do you rank them? Let me know. And is there anyone that you consider to be greater? You know, are they in your top five list? Do you think they stand shoulder to shoulder with the great ones like Sabbath and Zeppelin, that sort of thing? So give me an idea of where you rank them. I rank them shoulder to shoulder with Zeppelin where it comes to musicianship. I think that they outpace Zeppelin just a little bit when we're talking about their live performances. I think they match them where it comes to the studio performance. I think that they actually outpace them where it comes to their performances live. I like them better live than I do Zeppelin live. So that's saying something right there. But you let me know. Don't be influenced by what I like and what I don't like. You tell me where you rank these gents in regards to their musicianship. Other things too, you know, creativity, longevity, their great image, that sort of thing. Just let me know what you think of them, because I hold them in very, very high regard. So that's my reaction, man. Let me just scroll down here and see if I've got any notes for myself going forward. Okay, yeah, no notes, man, but I just wanted to give a shout out to Thor. Let me get your full name, Thor6471. Thor, thank you again, man. Appreciate it. And as well, too, let me know what other Rush songs I should react to. And I'm particularly really digging these nice long Odyssey-type songs, you know, taking you on a little bit of a trip mentally and giving you a great message to think and ponder about. I've come to really expect that from Rush, but I know that they're just not one-dimensional. I know that they've got other great songs like, you know, Tom Sawyer and that sort of thing. They've got some great rock tunes, whatever you feel, but let me know what I should react to next where Rush is concerned. And I'll wait for and compare some of your recommendations and then go from there. Ultimately, I'll probably react to all of their music, but I'm going based on solely what you're recommending to me. And yeah, that's how I'm going to basically approach Rush. I've always been approaching Rush that way. I approach Zeppelin one way, I approach Sabbath a different way, I'm approaching Rush a certain way, you know, so there's a couple of different ways that I proceed with different groups. So let me know what particular Rush song. I really, really like their great Odyssey songs, but I know that there's a lot more to them, so let me know about that. Anyway, man, that's my reaction. Thanks very much for joining me. Hope you liked it, and get back to me as to which reaction you want to see next for Rush, and I'll catch you in my next Rush reaction. Peace.